Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We're talking about the tricks of Shaytan in the month of Ramadan. And like I've been saying before, just because we know that the Shayateen are tied up, it doesn't mean all of the Shayateen are tied up. Shaytan, for example, or our personal Shaytan, may not be tied up as well. So Shaytan can very much influence us in the month of Ramadan. Now, one of the things which is common and people usually fall in one of two extremes regarding this issue, that is the issue of the iftar or iftar parties. And so you'll hear some people say that no, you should never have an iftar party because people end up eating too much food, blah blah blah, so you should never have an iftar party. On the other hand, you hear people say that, you know what, you should definitely have iftar parties and so on and so forth. And as you know, the truth usually lies in the middle. Iftar parties are actually a very, very good thing as long as some conditions are met. It's very good because, alhamdulillah, in the month of Ramadan, you feed someone and subhanAllah, you get the reward of every single person that you have fed. And so I always say, you know, iftar parties are actually good as long as the other acts of worship, or for example, our Taraweeh prayer or Maghrib prayer or Isha prayer, they're not suffering because of the iftar party. Or, subhanAllah, one of the problems with iftar parties is sometimes we'll commit sins during this iftar party. This subhanAllah goes against the whole spirit of the month of Ramadan, where we're supposed to cut out all sins. Obviously, we cut out all sins in the whole year, but especially where we work extra hard in the month of Ramadan. So make sure that, yeah, have the iftar party. Alhamdulillah, make the intention that you're feeding your brothers and sisters. Make the intention that you're bringing people together. Make the intention that you are encouraging one another to do goodness. And all that are great reasons to have iftar parties. But just make sure that the iftar party is not causing you, like I said, delay your maghrib or not pray isha or delay your taraweeh or not pray taraweeh at all. Alhamdulillah, one of the sunnahs, I think, one of the things that we can all implement is invite people over for iftar, but use that as an encouragement, encouraging people to worship Allah and say, you know what, alhamdulillah, we had a nice iftar, let's go pray maghrib together. Alhamdulillah, we had a nice iftar, let's go pray isha and let's go catch taraweeh together as a congregation. And by that, subhanAllah, you can defeat Shaytan, no matter how much he tries to convince you that, you know, khalas, just enjoy yourself, it's a iftar party, everyone's here together. You can defeat Shaytan by doing multiple acts of worship. Not only are you feeding one another, you're feeding your brothers and sisters, you're also encouraging one another to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Until next time, inshaAllah ta'ala, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.